What's going on today, people? It is the early morning hours of November 25th, 2016. It's pretty cold out. Not really cold, but cold enough. It's about -8 outside right now. We're going to go out and test out this bat light, iProtec bat light. We're going to go check it out, see how it performs in the dark. Let's get to it. Okay, people, here we are on a very dark trail right here. There's a few street lights in the background. We're gonna light up the trail here straight ahead. 200 lumen Nebo iProtec bat light. I gotta tell you, this light is actually quite bright. I can see quite far down that path there. I'm going to go further into this park. And I'm going to pace off a sign. Maybe do a beam test at 35 meters or something like that. Stay tuned for that. What we're looking at here, people, is a sign marking a trailhead. It is 25 meters away. I've zoomed in the viewfinder here, so the sign appears to be about the same size as it is to the naked eye. 25 yards with the Nebo iProtec bat light. It's pretty bright. I can definitely see that sign from here. 25 yards. We're going to go back to 35. Here is the sign at 35 yards. I'm going to go back another 10, 45, possibly go all the way back to 50. I'm not sure if I can get all the way back to 50. I'm going to try. Here's what the sign looks like at 50 yards. I was going to go back to 45, but I decided to come all the way back to 50. We're just going to sweep the tree line here. Again, these trees, I've zoomed in so they look approximately the same size as they do to the naked eye. I'm going to zoom out here. Bear with me. Zoomed all the way out. I could very easily see anybody in those woods there. Lighting up a trail here. I would say, people, thought I heard something. I would say the maximum distance of this beam, or max effective distance, I'd say, would probably be about 50 yards or 50 meters. Somewhere in around there. It's really bright inside of there. I wasn't really impressed at how bright that sign was at 50 yards. But for lighting up a trail like this, it works just great. I'm pretty impressed with that. We're gonna go back to the bunker now, and I'll give you some final thoughts on the light.
It's my coffee. Delicious. All right, people, we're back at the bunker here with my final thoughts on the Nebo ProTec or iProtec. I don't know which one it is. I've seen it spelled both ways. I've seen it spelled ProTec and iProtec. We're just going to call it the Nebo iProtec Batlight. We're going to give some what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and whether or not I recommend it. First of all, things that I like about the light. First of all, it's just cool. I mean, there's not really anything more I have to say about that. It's just a neat concept. And I know this has been around for a few years, but like I said in the previous video, it'll be in a card somewhere. I seen this at Bass Pro. I had to pick it up. I had to give it the ultimate test, people. I know that there are other bat lights by other companies, but the whole concept behind the bat light is just neat, in my opinion. I think it's cool. Like, it's just... Yeah, I don't really need to say much more. I do like the knurling on the handle. It's very grippy. It most likely will not slip out of your hand. I don't have any problem with this rubber coating up here. I don't know if that's a shock absorber or what that's for exactly. I don't have a problem with it. And I do like the 8-hour runtime on the 4 included AA batteries. That's pretty attractive. 8 hours of continuous runtime off of 4 AA's, 200 lumen. That's pretty good. Now, things that I don't like about the light, and there are a few. First of all is this tactical tail cap. I don't like this thing at all. First and foremost, there's no momentary, like there's no soft press to activate the light. You actually have to click the light, or click the tail cap rather, to activate the light. Then you can soft press through the modes. There's no initial soft touch. I don't like that one bit. Secondly, the modes themselves. There's not a whole lot of difference between the 200 lumen and the 100 lumen modes. There's minimal difference as far as I'm concerned. And the strobe mode, I wish they would just get rid of it. I wish this would just be a 200 lumen only light. I think that would be perfect. And obviously with a different interface in the back there. What else don't I like about this? The beam distance is not that great. They say 125 meters on the package. I would say 50, 60 tops for an effective range. That's usually how you can gauge things, people, with any type of flashlight. You just take the manufacturer's, whatever they call it, printed throw of the light. Say it's 300 meters, they say the light will go out to have that 150, and that's generally the useful light, the useful throw of the light rather. That's what I found anyway. The other thing that makes it cool, you know, obviously the shape of the bat also makes it not so cool, because there's how are you going to carry this? I had to put this in a backpack tonight. Went into 7-Eleven to get a coffee, had to put this in my backpack, because there's no putting this in your pocket. I guess you could put it down your pants, but would that be considered a concealed weapon? I don't know, and I think it would be up to, it'd be up to somebody else, not you, to determine that. Now, what else don't I like about this? That's really about it, to be honest with you. Now, do I recommend this light? Outside of a novelty item, not really. I would like to see the price, you know, a little bit less, obviously. I mean, everybody obviously would like any product that they buy to be less money. But I think a $30 or $40 price point for this light is more appropriate than $50. I'm speaking to my Canadian audience here. I don't know how much this costs in the States. It's probably like $20 down there. Who knows? But do I recommend this? I don't know. It's neat. It's fun to have. It's a neat thing to have, like in a collection or something. But for any useful, practical purpose, I don't really see much of a use for it. Maybe keep it in your vehicle just in case you might need, you know, something. You know, people are crazy out on those roads. That road rage, the people are nuts. I've seen, you know, personally, I've seen some crazy-ass stuff. But I don't know. I neither recommend nor not recommend this. It's up to you guys. Kind of a novelty item, but yeah, it's neat. Check it out. Bat light.